members of the judiciary converged at the High Court in Kampala to mourn the fallen Supreme Court Justice Stella Arach-Amoko. A motion to appreciate the contributions of the deceased has been raised by the Attorney General Chiriowa Chiwanuka, and it was seconded and passed without hesitation by other law officers, led by Bernard Owundo, the President of the Uganda Law Society.
We granted to the Honorable, to the judicial officers and staff of the judiciary to commemorate the Honorable Lady Justice Mary Stella.
The court session was presided over by Lady Justice Faith Monda, who also seconded the motion on behalf of other members of the judiciary, who include Percy Knight Tuhaise, Elizabeth Mosoke, Mike Chibita, Stefan Musota, and Christopher Madrama. She highlighted on the rules that have to be followed.
She was a mother. She was a mentor. She was respectful. She was courteous. Those are some of the tributes that we have received.
Protection of the family and the East African community legal aid and charity. She was a jurist. She worked for the decentralization of the Law Development Center.
She was a very, very faithful spouse and partner. That's why we had no problems.
Ambassador James Amoko, the husband to the deceased, also joined the judiciary to mourn the late. He has remembered the late as a trustworthy leader who distanced herself from corruption. He also thanked the president, the judiciary, and all those who have stood with his family during this trying moment.
She strengthened our partnership with development partners and greatly improved our profile as an association.
Was a distinguished jurist with exceptional ability and expertise, especially in civil matters.
For all of us, it was not difficult to be proud of just Stella. She was somebody you were never ashamed of being associated with.
One by one, members of the judiciary eulogized the late and highlighted her contributions to the judicial system. The judiciary has also thanked the president for according the fallen Supreme Court Justice a state funeral. The Deputy Chief Justice, Richard Butera, has read out the message from the Chief Justice Alphonse Owinyidolo, and he gave information about the late.
Although soft-spoken, the late Justice Arach-Amoko was candid and objective. She endeavored to uphold her judicial oath in the face of many challenging circumstances, and her judgments are testimony enough that she was always guided by the facts and the law in her decisions.
She was a confidant whose wise counsel I always sought.
Amoko died on Saturday last week at the age of 69, and by the time of her death, she was remaining with only 1 year to retire from the judicial service. Report compiled by Joseph Innocent Sinfuma for the news.